MPs from both the AIADMK as well as the DMK united earlier in the day in Parliament to take on the government over its disturbing silence on Lanka. While an angry DMK slammed the centre for failing to protect the lives of Tamils from Lanka, the AIADMK expressed concerns over the rise in attacks on fishermen which have become routine, along with Lanka's aggression.
I think nowadays, the voice of Tamils are not heard or considered properly by Government of India. Neither the voices of Sri Lanka Tamils, nor the voices of Indian Tamils, nor the voices of diaspora world over. I feel sorry, madam. Government is adopting a stoic silence on this very human rights violation issue.
Day before yesterday, 22 fishermen from the Rameshwaram area, they have been captured and arrested by the Lankan Navy. Yesterday, again, 16 fishermen from Rameshwaram, Pamban and Tangachimudam, they have been arrested and taken to the prison in Sri Lanka, sir. This is becoming a repeated episode, and this is an assault on our national sovereignty.
Thank you.
I do not know
what our
Indian government is doing.
There must be sanctions, must be imposed where they are to be found after adjudication, and a life of dignity and life of equality must be ensured to all the civilian citizens of Sri Lanka. This was the objective of supporting the resolution last year, and the objective remains important, and we are constant in pursuit of that objective. Whatever steps are necessary towards the pursuit of that objective will be taken by Government of India.